This will be a demo for the AP cycle, from creating a vendor to creating a purchase order, all the way through paying the bill and checking out the AP aging report for a customer. So we'll start off by creating a vendor. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to lists, relationships, vendors, and then we can click new. If we click on this vendors, it'll bring up the full list. So we're going to click new and create ourselves a new vendor. Just as an example, we're going to call this one Apple. And then as you can see up here in the vendor ID, it has automatically come over. It is a company. We can fill in this address if we'd like to. For this vendor example, I'm not going to. If we wanted to fill in the email of our direct contact or the email where any vendor specific information should go, we would put it here in this emails tab. If we want to go for a phone number, just the generic phone number that we would call for this vendor, we would put it in this phone field. So you just fill in all of this information. Here you would put any financial information that you have for them. If you have a credit limit, you would put that in this field down here at the bottom. So just kind of an example. So we're going to go ahead and save this vendor. And now it has been created. You can see here it's created today, 8:25. So this will automatically be populated through. Let's say we need to go back in and we need to edit this vendor. So I'll go into edit. And let's say we actually do want to set on a phone number. So we can go ahead and set that right down here. And if we wanted to set an email address, we could. Let's just put this email address in. If we wanted to give them an address, we could go into address right here. So this one's saying it may have a duplicate, probably because of that phone number. It's saying you may have a duplicate here. You can ignore this one if it's not actually a duplicate. It's just giving you a warning. So now on the address field or subtab, we can go over here to this little pencil icon on the right side of the screen. And this will actually bring up the edit field for this address, for this company's address. So once it finally loads up, we can go ahead and set in the address. Let's go ahead and set that. Cost 40. So we would just set all of this information in. Automatically came through for me because it had been input before. So now I can click OK, and there it is. Finishes filling in all of the information. And now I can hit save, and this record will now be updated. So here's all their information, you know, the address, here's the phone number and email address that we put in. We want to look at information, if there are any other relationships for this vendor, they would show up here. So let's head back to the dashboard through the little home button. And now we would want to create a purchase order. So I'm going to go to transactions, purchases, enter purchase orders. Now, you could also do this through the employee center role. There'll be a nice blue button for purchase orders if you wanted to create one from there. That role would automatically set the employee as whoever is logged in. So that is this field right here, employee, would be whoever's logged in. I'm gonna set it as John Luke here. We're gonna choose our Apple vendor. And there they are. So this information here, this employee, that would automatically be filled in if you were going through the employee center role, or if you didn't have as much permissions as the administrator does. So this could be auto set to be whoever the current user is. So we're going to go down here. Here's the first information. Some of these fields on the right side of the information, this mainline information, there's a lot of customized fields for this account for the purchase order workflow, which we can do at a later time. So we're going to come over here. We're going to choose items because we know which item it is that we want to purchase. I want to purchase an Apple iPad. And we're going to be purchasing 50 of them, just as an example. And we're going to purchase them at, let's change this to 250. So we can change the rate, that the amount will automatically be calculated by the quantity and the rate. Call this Apple iPad for resale. This description here, that would be kind of more information if it was needed. Let's say you were purchasing a specific computer. You would put in, you say, the serial number or the other specifications. You could put that in right here on this description. And then we can click Add, and that'll add that in. We could also go back into the line, and we can choose a department if we want to. So let's call it operations. Actually, sales is actually a little bit better. We'll choose sales. If we wanted a class, we can call this new business. So it's kind of those are the fields that we would need, or we could put in. Could also put some of that information up here. And if we wanted to put in a memo, this would be more of a, reason for the purchase, something like that would be put in on the memo field. So once we click save, then it will go to this employee's supervisor for approval, which I have set up to be the current logged in user. So it should come up for approval once it finishes saving. So now, as you can see, there's a nice blue approve button and then a reject button. So this would go to this person's supervisor, and I could, as a supervisor, I would then be able to go in, review, what it is that they're trying to purchase, and I can approve or reject it. In this case, I'm going to approve the purchase orders because we need more stock iPads. All right, so now it's been approved, it goes out, and as you can see here, there's a receive button instead of a bill button. That's because for the inventory items, we want to receive the inventory, and then have that three-way matching where we have the purchase order, we have the item itself, and the item receipt, and then we would have the vendor bill. So we'd first receive. And this could be done by someone in our warehouse. If we have it shipped to the warehouse, we could have that person have the ability to create item receipts. So here they are. We're going to put this in the San Jose location, 50 of them, and we will click save. It's going to, as you can see, it's created from the vendor. All kind of comes over from that purchase order. So we'll save this. And then now this is able to be billed. So if I go back to this purchase order, if I go created from and go back to the purchase order, now instead of the receive button, now we can see that there is a bill button. So now we can actually create the vendor bill by clicking that button. And again, the information is going to be automatically created from the purchase order, all 50 of them that were received. If we had only received 30 of them, 30 would be available to be billed. Here's the unit rate that we have. Everything comes over just the same. So I'm just going to click save on this. So now that this vendor bill has been created, now we need to pay the bill. When you make the payment, you can either make the payment from the vendor or you can make it from the bill itself. As you can see right here is a make payment button. It's right at the top. So you could click that to make a vendor payment and it would link directly to this bill. Or if you would go down here to the vendor field, we can click that vendor. And there will be a make payment button as well on this vendor. So I'll create it from the vendor. And just as an example, I'm only going to pay for half of this. So, or just 5,000. So we're gonna check which one we need to pay, and then I'm gonna change the payment on the right side of the screen to 5,000. That's right over here. Pay is Apple. It automatically comes over because we clicked it from the vendor. If we need to put any classification information for this payment, we could. This account is, which account the cash will be coming out of. The amount up here at the top is going to be based off of all of the bills that are trying to be paid and the amount of this payment. Once we have that, now we can click save and that will actually process the payment and log it into NetSuite and say that this amount has been paid to the vendor. And we could do this, we would go back to payee as your vendor. So we will go back to the vendor. And if we wanted to, we could finish off the payment. We could make another payment to finish off this this vendor bill. But instead, I'd like to show you the vendor dashboard. So when we're on the vendor screen, there's this little dial icon right next to vendor. And if you hover over it, it'll say dashboard. So we click on this little dial, and it'll actually bring us to some key information. There's some KPIs, useful links, and all the transactions for this vendor. So I want to look at the AP aging for this vendor. And it'll show me what is the current balance for them. If I wanted to, I could change the aging options. Let's say I wanted to make the age based on, as of a different date. So I'm gonna change this to be 9/25. And I'm gonna change the aging to be based off of the transaction date. So when I click okay, now that'll log everything in. And then I can click refresh and then it'll change all the way to over here. So total balance is still the 7,500. And then here in our 60-day bucket is 7,500. And that's because we've switched a couple things around on it. If I switch it back to based on the due date and refresh, it's gonna drop it into the same 60-day bucket. Because it's the very end of it, very end of the 60-day bucket. So that's the AP aging based on the vendor. I'm gonna go back to the vendor dashboard. And another interesting report is we can see the AP payment history by either the payment or by the bill. So let's first look at it by the bill. And we can see, okay, here's the bill and here's the bill payment. So the $12,500 and then the $5,000 payment. And we can see that there's a amount remaining still for $7,500 for this bill. If we add a second payment, the payment's gonna show up down here as well. So that's one of the cool things about NetSuite is it actually lets you show the report based off of many different options. That's it for this one. Thank you.